Good morning, viewers. Welcome back to fifth episode of the Meet the Media Veteran series. Today in the episode, we have a very versatile actress of Indian cinema who is known for her very powerful roles. Her illustrious career ranges from theater to television and to cinema. And I welcome the very talented actress of Indian cinema, Rajeshwari Sachdev, to the show.
Thank you so much. Can you hear me?
Yeah, very warm welcome to the show, Rajeshwari. Before formally starting the session, let me give a brief introduction to the Rajeshwari to the viewers first. Rajeshwari Sachdev is a film, television and theatre actress who is known for some of the most powerful roles she has portrayed in films and television. After completing her graduation from Guru Nanak Khalsa College in Mumbai, she started her career on stage doing plays with IPTA, Indian People Theatres Association. Sachdev made her debut with the Marathi film Ayatya Gharat Garoba, directed by Sachin in 1991. Her second film was with Shyam Benegal, Suraj Ka Satwa Ghoda in 1992. She then acted most of the Shyam Benegal films. She was cast in Mammo in 1994, Sadari Begum in 1996, Summer in 1999, Hari Bhari 2000, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, The Forgotten Hero in 2005, and Welcome to Sajjanpur in 2008. She has also appeared in, you know, very powerful Hollywood films like Little Buddha, directed by none other than Bernardo Bertolucci, and Tales of Calms of the Perfumed Garden in 1998. She also worked in the show Samvidhan, directed by Shyam Benegal. In Shyam Benegal's film Sardari Begum in 1996, she won the National Award for the Best Supporting Actress, which is a very, you know, big honor for any actor. Sachdev has also co-hosted a very popular ZTV musical show, Antakshri, from 1994 to 2001 with Anu Kapoor. She also worked in crime TV series Rihai, where she portrayed a role of an activist. She has acted in over 40 feature films and TV shows in multiple languages like Marathi, Hindi and Urdu. Huge body of work, actually. I welcome you once again, Rajeshwari, to the show. And to moderate today's session, we have with us today very prominent Indian film critic and writer, Mr. Saibal Chatterjee. Welcome to the show, Mr. Saibal Chatterjee.
Thank you, Rizwan.
So without any delay, now may I request Mr. Saibal Chatterjee to kindly begin the session. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you. Okay, it's great to have you, Rajeshwari, on the show. And I'm sure
thank
we'll
you
have...
so much. I'm so excited that I'm here with you. I'm actually so delighted. I must tell you that.
Thank you. So anyway, I mean, like Rizwan, I mean, gave us an idea of where your career began. You've been a part of the industry, but I see you still as an outsider. I mean, not really a Bollywood actress. Okay, so how did you did this happen by accident, or did you? Is it a conscious choice not to sort of, you know, get into the rat race and become a Bollywood actress? You've never been a Bollywood actress in that sense.
Honestly, I really do not have an answer to that one. Because, see, when I started, it wasn't your conventional beginning. And
yeah,
30 years back, that's not how things were supposed to be. And there were these commercial films that were happening. And especially for women, there was not much to do. You ended up being a phooldaan. But as luck would have it, I was just maybe at that point of time at the right place at the right time. I was very young, just out of school. And the first opportunity that I got, and I was doing theater since my childhood, because at that point of time, it wasn't about doing theater. It was, you should spend evenings there, because my father in the GT was associated with the Indian People's Theater Association. So, hum sare bacche bhi wahan hote the. And by the way, we started, you know, in the crowd scenes and then I started doing other plays. I will definitely come to that again. That's a very interesting part of my life. But when I did, you know, before I did the Marathi film, I was supposed to be launched in a commercial cinema. For some reason, I couldn't do it. And then I got Sachin's Marathi film. And that's because I'm born and brought up in Maharashtra. I do speak the language. And it was a fantastic part to play. Now, I was all of 15 and a half, 16 when I started shooting for that film. And I thought, chalo, yeh kar lete hain, you know. I always felt that I wanted to act, but one wasn't really sure which way things were going to go. That film got me my state award for the best actress, and I said, "Arey, I'm supposed to be good." But what I always felt in the industry was, A, I wasn't conforming to the rules of how a heroine should look. I always had my own little streak of maybe a chip on my shoulder. I'm an actor, you know. If you want to imagine me in a certain way, then it's your job, and I can play the part. So I never looked the part, but there were these few directors who wanted to work with me, and I, of course, learned a lot from them and wanted to work with them. Yeah. When I did the Marathi film, the so-called, I know I've heard that. So they said, "Huh, you are the best actress, but it's a Marathi film, you know." Then I did Suraj Ka Saatwa Ghoda. Arey yaar, wo to art film hai. You know, and then you did third film that I did was Bertolucci's Little Woman. Arey wo Hollywood hai yaar, Bollywood ki baat karo. But somehow I always found myself a little away. Maybe also because of the kind of choices that I made earlier on. Though much later, a very senior actor did tell me that, you know, to be seen in that that one great film, you have to do a whole lot of nonsensical films to be there and then become commercially viable. Yeah. But at that point, the kind of films those were that were offered to me really didn't have any meat. And I was doing Aita Ghara Gharuba. I was doing Suraj Ka Saatwa Ghoda. I was doing Triya Charitra with Vashuda. And all these roles, though I was very young, I didn't understand much. I was just going with what, you know, when you begin, you're very raw. You understand what you're doing, but not completely. And you're enjoying what you're doing because you're working with the best of them. So obviously, I didn't want to be a part of those. So maybe what followed after that in films was a result of the decisions that I took initially.
Yeah. So you said your father was a part of IPTA. So the yes. acting bug would have bitten you very early. So how early was that? I mean, did you start acting as a child, or did you wait till, I mean, you attained?
We were only a part of theatre at that point. And agar theatre ke kisi ka kuch ho, to we used to go for that one day shoot. But I think what we all did was all IPTA bachchas were in one show for one day shoot. But no, I didn't really professionally start acting. Mm. I think what happened then was that I was learning classical dance. So my father always thought I had it in me. So at the age of 5, I have a South Indian mother and a Sudar as a father. So I'm quite a combination. And my father said, you know, she looks like she has a lot of sense of rhythm and she should dance. So at the age of 5, my mother took me to Rajarajeshwari School of Dance for Bharatanatyam training. And I used to enjoy it. I think that's one place where it's very spiritual for me to go and dance on stage. I always thought I'm going to dance and I'm going to be on stage. Now, there were some evenings in a week where we used to go to rehearsals when IPTA ke plays hote the. So, wahan hum chupa chupai bhi khelte the. There was Shelly Sathyu, there was Sagar, all of us. And I think we got initiated because wo kehte na kaano mein cheeze padti hain aapke. So, here you had Shabana Azmi rehearsing, Hangal Saab rehearsing, you have M.S. Sathyu directing a play. So, how can you not, you know, how can you not absorb those things? So I guess somewhere, and also I must say that I used to feel very important when I was on stage, especially at Prithvi, when I used to do this play called Bakri, directed by M.S. Sathyu. So at Prithvi Theatre, you have these two entrances, okay? So in between a play, we used to go from one place and go from the canteen and come from the other entrance. Now for me, that was the best part, okay? Because I was in costume, little kid. And I used to go out and everybody in that Prithvi canteen would turn and look, oh, there's an actor. And I used to feel so good. I can't tell you. I think all of that put together, yes, maybe I did want to act. Maybe it was there. And then things started happening. I didn't really go after it. But when one after the other, initially, if you get that kind of work, you want to, you feel, yes, maybe I am cut out for it.
Yeah. So, I mean, you are almost part of, you know, like the Shyam Benegal repertory company. I mean, you're there. I mean, you've been in almost every film of his after being, you know, after being in Suraj Ka Saatwa Ghoda when you must have been very young. So as you grew and you, as you kept working with Shyam Babu, how did you see yourself evolve as an actress? How how important was Shyam Babu's role in your life as an actress?
You know, to put it in words will not be easy. To say that, oh, I used to sit and chat with him for hours, no, I would listen to him. I would just sit there and watch him. And I realized this was a man who was so well-read. This was a man who had answers to everything. And I guess subconsciously you take in a lot, the choices that you make, the way you think. I could never say what, but I think he is somebody who's groomed me. Even when I had to study, even if I had college, even if I had to do my master's, I would go and ask him, what did he think? Show him my mark sheet too. I think the kind of choices that I made, the kind of person I am or the actor that I am, he is very largely responsible for that. There's some, you become a little more conscious of the surroundings that you are. There is certain responsibility to being an actor.
Yeah. Yes. I mean, yeah, in fact, every conversation you have with Shyam Babu, you actually take something away because he's somebody who's so erudite and, you know, so knowledgeable about things.
He was about everything.
Yeah. I mean, history, food, cinema, music.
So you ask him which year was nylon made and he will have an answer to that. I mean, come on.
Yeah. But you also worked with Bernardo Bertolucci. I mean, would you like to share your memories about that bit of your life? I mean,
you know, that too happened by chance. So we got a call one day that Bertolucci's casting director was here in town and he wanted to meet. And I'm like, okay, you know.
Mil lete hain, Jack.
Haan, mil lete hain. See, you know, what happened was in my career graph that I was never really auditioned for anything because Mr. Benegal I had met as a child because my father had worked in Discovery of India. So I remember going to this party and I was very excited. I was in school then. So I had met him then. And after which we did Suraj Ka Saath. So Mr. Benegal, in all the films that I have done, I've never been auditioned. Okay, he just kind of trusts you, and which is fantastic. So I said, "Acha, milne jana, okay, chalo milte hain." And what was again very nice here was that Mr. Castellani, we just conversed and everything was on camera. The next thing I know was that Bertolucci wanted to meet me. And then I somehow had a feeling I'm going to work with him. And I'm thinking somebody who comes from somewhere, Saat Samandar Paar, wants to work with you, things are just kind of rolling for you.
Yeah.
And after which I met him straight on location. And I realized something about these directors. They are so calm on their sets. They are so self-assured that it rubs off onto you. And working with him again, it was, I think I was there for about 10 to 14 days, though we shot only not more than about 4 to 5 days. It was quite an experience for me because
Where was this? In Nepal.
I was working with a unit which was massive. I saw this unit jahan koi are udhar se ye hilao wo hatao nahi ho raha hai, you know. I had worked with the commercial cinema people too here, and everything was so much larger than life, so big, and everything was so organized. Of course, I had worked with Mr. Bennington, I had worked with such who are very organized people. But here it was another level in terms of the whole unit. I remember there was a scene we were going to shoot outdoors and suddenly it began raining. And we lost a good 2 hours. And the production head was going crazy. He says, no, we can't afford to lose 2 hours. In 2 hours, they had set up another set indoors and we canned the scene. It was, I mean, we shot the whole scene. It was quite a revelation. If it had happened in those days here in Mumbai, we would have called for backup. So there were a lot of things. I like the way they were organized, the kind of importance that actors got. I enjoyed all that attention. There was this lady always with me who, even if I raised my head, she would be there. Yes, you need something. And I said, why is that? And I realized that they want you to be so disconnected with everything else around you and just focus on your work. It was really wonderful. to be given that kind of space and freedom at the same time to work.
I can't see you over there. They'll put me back, I think. Can you hear me? You can hear me.
Yes, now I can. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. So to come back to...
It's very weird, you know, looking at myself and talking.
So, I mean, I saw you in Gauhar last year on the stage, and you said that you are a trained dancer. So was this the first occasion that you were actually dancing and singing to this extent on the stage? And I must say that I was blown away by the performance and the play.
So how
tough was it, you know, preparing for that part? Singing, dancing, acting, you know, doing the whole thing within that, you know, time frame, which must be really tough. Yes. And how many performances have you done of that?
I think we've crossed about 65-70 shows, I think, if I'm
and
not
it's still
wrong.
On. I mean, you'll still be doing it. I mean, it's not like over. Yeah. So to talk us through the experience of, you know, getting into the spirit of Gauhar.
When Lilette Dubey offered me this part, I was so kicked, and I told her, I said, but you know, I'm not a classical singer. She said, yes, I'm aware. I said, and when do we want to open the play? And there wasn't much time, and I was already committed to doing the show that I was doing those days. And you know, wo lalach hoti hai, and I just didn't want to pass that opportunity and say that, oh, listen, but I am doing something else, and I won't have so much time to do this. I said, you know, this is a challenge and I must just take it. Now, the point was that it's easier said than done. Acting ho jayegi, dancing bhi ho jayegi. Now, what do you do about classical singing? So, every day I would be traveling to Naigaon for my shoot, and I would carry the music pieces with me, and all through that 1 hour journey back and forth, I would only be exercising my vocal cords. And I told her, I said, you know, I don't know how well I'm going to sing the first show or the second show, but I promised myself that by the time we have done about 20 shows, I'll be quite there. And I think I lived up to that promise. It was a challenge. You know, as an actor, you look for varied things to do. Not that, oh, I haven't done this, so I want to do this. You know, you have it in you. At least if what you don't have, you will work hard towards. And yes, maybe you will not be successful the first time, but you would have attempted something, and you have enough opportunities to just get better and better with this. And you grow as an actor. And you can't do that until you have taken up the challenge. So I didn't want to be scared and say no. It was a tough time the thing about Gauhar was that she lived her life, hum kehte na saptam ke sur pe, everything, she was so passionate about everything, the kind of emotions that she had, the way she loved, the way she sang, the way she performed, everything was high-pitched. Now, in a two-hour play, to get her entire life, you obviously have the high points of her life. So it drained me completely each time. So the day I have two shows, I go crazy. But yes, I am very glad I did that play. And every time that I'm performing that play, I know that there is something new that comes out of it. Sometimes the show isn't as good as the previous one, or you don't know, maybe you'll have bring in a new element sometime else. But yes, that is a play that has evolved me as an actor in terms of the different art forms, even Kathak for that matter. I'm not a Kathak dancer. So naturally what happens is I end up having the stance of a Bharatanatyam dancer. So you have to unlearn a lot and then learn again. So that is, I think, very important for an actor.
So, I mean, you played the daughter of a woman who would have been similar to Gauhar. I mean, in Sardari Begum, you play Sakina to Sardar. So was that a reference point when you were preparing for Gauhar, or...
Mahesh Satani has written this play. Can I have you on screen, please? Because it's very disconcerting to just look at myself and talk.
Yeah, please. Thank you.
Vikram Sampath. Again.
you carry on. You can
we'll yeah, we'll sort I can talk to the mirror and say, oh, you know me yeah, and I. Yeah. So Vikram Sampath.
So did you read the book first, Vikram Sampath's book, before you?
Yes. I am so glad he wrote that book. It's such an extensively written book about her. It's amazing how he's brought so many things about her life together. That really, really helps. There was so much about her personality that you could imbibe. Maybe you don't see it as a scene, but as an actor, it allows you to give you so many layers. Things that wouldn't be said in your lines and your scenes, but you could get it in your attitude in the character. It is an amazing life that the woman led. And I'm so glad that Vikram Sampath, I think, put in 5 or 6 years of his life to create this. And I wouldn't have been able to go her this effectively had it not been for that book.
Yeah. So, and then you also read the play that the text obviously was used for the play. So when you do a play, I mean, unlike a film where you, once a shot is canned, it's canned. It's a part of history. But on the stage, you can evolve as you go along, and every performance is a new performance. So if we see, say, these 65 shows, would each show have its own character, or do you sort of get to a point as an actor where you figure out that this is what it's going to be and you keep repeating that every time? I mean, at what point do you reach there?
I believe that what happens in theater is, yes, you get to rehearse a lot. You get to make your structure. And after a point, you start performing. Now, you might have thought of a lot of things. You must have worked on, rehearsed on a lot of things. But every show that you do gives you a different set of challenges. And no two shows can be alike. There are times where that one particular show is fantastic and you don't know why it turned out the way it did. And you keep trying. I remember doing this play called Shatranj Ke Mohre, and that one show, there is this piece where Geeta talks of a plight in the ashram. And somehow, in spite of all my rehearsals, never in any of the rehearsals had I performed that way. And it was, you just feel it inside. You thought, I don't know what I did today, but it was fantastic. It was a 6 p.m. show. And then I'm hoping and praying to the gods. I don't know what that was, but can I just repeat it in the 9 o'clock show? And I said, Ari, yaar, wo to hoga nahi na, because I don't know how that happened. In the 9 o'clock show, the same thing happened. I said, wow, did I crack it or what? The next weekend, I had another show. I could not get it again.
Okay.
I just didn't know what you know, that happens. That what also happens is, when you've done enough shows, complacency sets in. You feel, oh, if I push the right buttons, this is the emotion that's going to come out of it. And I've realized that you can't allow that to happen. It does happen. And you have to reinvent yourself and invest yourself again and say, listen, one can't do this. So you have to invest a little more. And I have a director who will ensure that we do that. So yes, every show will be different. And it should be different. You know, there are things that you want to try. I want to do this differently. It might work, it might not work. But as an actor, that's how I think you will grow. Because you know you're trying different things. It's like learning something. You might attempt something, and of course with the hope that this is going to be fantastic. And if it's not, then you at least know what you're not to do the next time. Yes, it's a constantly evolving process. Theater allows you to do that. Yes.
Yeah. So, and as an actor for the big screen, I mean, are there moments when you see something and you see yourself and you think, oh, maybe if given another chance, I would do it differently? I mean, does a lot of actors say that you know, we always feel that maybe, you know, but do you also feel that way? Or, I mean, are you okay with letting it go and, you know, moving on?
I would let it go. Yeah. Because it's done. It was done in a period of time. Nothing you can do about it. It was done at a particular time. You were a certain age with a certain amount of maturity, a certain amount of experience. And it was just right for that moment, I guess. You just learn from that what not to do. When I used to be a child and maybe when I just watch performances, I, apart from the good performances, I used to insist on seeing the bad performances to just know what
the difference
not to do. Yes, so that was my learning.
So another recent work of yours that I liked was Firebrand, which was on a streaming platform. And that was obviously a completely different world for you, I mean, from Gauhar, because Gauhar is this woman from, you know, the early 19th century. And I mean, you have this modern, urban, highly strung woman in Firebrand. So would you like to talk about that performance as well? I mean, and again, Aruna Raje, who's a filmmaker who has a track record. And did you work with her before ever? No. This was our first.
We have been talking to each other for years and saying, we have to work together sometime. And this particular time she called me and she said, I have this part for you to do. And I was very excited about doing this part. There are so many gray areas to the character. Nowhere is the woman really bad. It's all your ambitions, all your demons. There's so much that you expect out of life. It was a very well-written part. And I thoroughly enjoyed doing it because this was something that I haven't played before. It was, you know, when you talk of women, there is no stereotyping this character. She was so alive in her own way.
Yeah, and you didn't even know what to make of her, yeah.
Yeah, so I quite like the ambiguity of the character at the same time. She could be anything, and yet I empathized with that character. And I hope that came across, because somewhere you felt that I wish it wasn't like that for her. Maybe, but this also comes from within your own space. This is what you expect out of life. And somewhere you lose that empathy towards other things. And that's when you become, hum kehte na, katu ho jate hain.
Yeah. And you know, you started your career in the early 90s. And I mean, it's only a coincidence. There's no connection. I mean, Shah Rukh Khan began in 1992. Your the same year as, you know, Deewana,
yes,
was your,
yes.
Okay. And 1990 was this decade of the designer film. You know, as we got to the mid 90s, we had Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge, and you know, all these Punjabi stories, Sarson Ka Sagas, as we used to call them.
Yes.
So didn't you ever have the urge to get into that world? I mean, I asked you this question.
I was a part of this film with Shah Rukh Khan. It was called English Babu Desi Mein. Yes. And
so you had a bunch of, so you did all that. You did all that.
Yes. And that film didn't do well. And there were these films that I did. They fell into the commercial bracket. But for some reason, either the film didn't release or it didn't do that well. And but they were good scripts too. There was this film that I did called Pyar Pyar, which was very interesting the way it was a comedy. It was a fun film. It didn't release. So, yeah, I was a part of that. I would have loved to be a part of that because I love dancing.
Obviously, yeah.
So I keep telling Mr. Benegal, why don't you make a film on a dancer? I would love to do that part.
He was planning to do Carmen in Hindi, but I think he was going to cast Priyanka Chopra. I've forgotten now. It was long back. Yeah. So,
long back.
Yeah. So, and television has been a large part of your professional life. So how important is television? I mean, you've been a host, you've acted in serials. And so has television been also a sustaining sort of factor for you as a creative person?
Yes. See, initially when I was doing, of course, I was, there was this thinking that you couldn't be a part of television if you wanted to be a film actor. So, yes, all that did come to me and even I felt that. But slowly with time, I realized that if I'm going to walk the beaten path, if I'm going to do exactly like everybody else has structured their careers, maybe I'll end up being nowhere. And there was a certain kind of work that I wanted to do. I also needed to earn the money, of course, and sustain myself. I also wanted to put all that I had in me out there. There was no point waiting for things to happen. So when I realized that this is not going to be very simple, And this was being offered to me so respectfully, and there's such good parts to play. Again, when it came to television, I was very fortunate to get the very good parts. So when they came to me with that, I think that becomes very important as an actor, that people trust you. They know you're going to bring this to the table, and then you don't want to refuse that. So yes, I even sang, I even got albums. So I nowhere claim to be a singer because I'm not trained as a singer.
Yeah.
So yes, so I'm around for 30 years because I now was creating a base in different media so that I had the choice to do the kind of work I wanted to do. I don't end up doing just anything because I need the work. So I would rather do a very good television series when nothing else was happening than do inconsequential stuff in movies. Yes. If that none of that was happening, I had theater because I had to keep polishing myself. I had to keep being there and being relevant. When it was about singing too, I first initially refused when I was asked to sing, cut an album, because I was hosting a show and I was singing on that show. So the music company saw me in that and I said, no, I am just a Punjabi girl who sings because all of us sing.
Yeah.
But eventually when I saw a whole lot of them cutting albums, I said, stupid girl, you should be doing
why
this.
Not me, yeah.
Why not me? I'm much better. All I need to do is work hard.
Log itna besura ga rahe the aapke liye.
Hum kyun nahi matlab itni mehnat to main kar hi lungi. See, and also then I felt, that, you know, if I'm going to say that, oh, I don't sing like Lata Mangeshkar, so I shouldn't sing, I think one can't do that to oneself. We all bring something else each time that we do something. It might be very small, but it's yours. And if people want you, people want to listen to you, you can't be thinking that you are the only intelligent one around here. Okay? So, yes, so I decided I will sing, and I decided I'll work towards it.
So,
and I really cut three music albums.
I know. You are now a legitimate singer. I mean, you're a full-fledged singer as well. I mean, apart from being an actress. I'll ask you about two specific characters you played. Rajkumari Amrit Kaur in Samvidhan and yes. Captain Lakshmi Sehgal in The Forgotten Hero. So when you play a historical figure, how tough is it? I mean, do you have to do a lot of reading or do you leave it to the director to... you know, bring you up to speed with what is required?
It works both ways, but I think you have to do your homework and you have to go there with your homework. And after that, yes, there is a writer who's written the script, who has a certain narrative, the way the film is going to flow, what all is going to be seen, what all is expected. Even for Captain Lakshmi Sehgal, I did go for training in rifle shooting. I had to do that. I said, you know, just for the stance, the body language, even if I'm not shown anywhere, you have to look right. And yes, I did read my books. I was very fortunate to meet Captain Lakshmi Sehgal when she was in Mumbai, speak to her. So yes, I think homework is imperative. You have to be doing your homework. And then of course the director guides you and what's not right, what isn't coming across. Like I said, we think of a lot of things, but many a times you're not able to execute it. You know, that can happen. But homework is a must. To say that, oh, it's all about spontaneity, no. Spontaneity comes later. After it's all there here, then you forget about it because then it's in your system. Then it's going to come out. It's going to come out spontaneously. That's what I believe.
So what kind of actor are you? What kind of actor are you? Are you an instinctive actor or do you do a lot of, you know, preparation to actually get into the skin of a character?
I believe that is preparation. There is an instinct. There is an instinct. There is something that you absorbed in your life, the things that you've seen that stays in your subconscious that you will apply. That's what creates that instinct. Okay. All that you've gained over the years. But I believe that, you know, if that's why I don't believe too much in auditions. Where people say, "Achha, ye line hai, kar lo." I don't believe in that. I would want to read the whole script. I would want to understand what it is all about. And many, it's not about something that happens overnight. You sit with it. There has to be some gestation period. I think somewhere along the way, if I know that this is what I have read, it starts working on your mind. You think about it, and then you perform. I think as an actor, I would call myself somebody who would like to go prepared. Yes.
Yeah. And what is the connection, I mean, that you have with Dharmveer Bharti? Your Suraj Ka Satwa Ghoda was based on a novel of his. And you just did this reading that I saw of Shabd Leela. So, I mean, have you done more of his work? I mean, have you... how did you choose Shabd Leela to do in this lockdown period?
You know, I've been very lucky. I've been surrounded by the best, nurturing, talented minds and people. I have been associated with the right people, you know, who have always encouraged me. They made me grow as a person. Now, Ila Harun and KK Raina, people that I know since a very long time. We did a play called Jameela Bai Kalali in 1992.
Oh.
And Suraj Ka Satwa Ghoda happened in 1992. That's when that's when I got to know about Dharmveer Bharti. And at that point of time, yes, I read the novel again. Whatever I understood of the novel, that age.
At that age, and, yeah.
Yes. Then I spoke to Shama Zaidi, who was writing the film, and then she explained to me things. My father used to insist that I said, see, I have to give complete credit for whatever I do, whatever approach that I have to my father, because he used to make me sit down with a pencil and say, okay, what do you think about it? What do you feel about it? Right. And then go and ask Shama Ji, what does she think? Are you on the right track? Are you thinking right? So that's how I approached my part when I did Suraj Ka Satwa. After which I read more of his works. And then last year, Ilaji said that I'm intending to do Dharmveer Bharti's works again. But there's going to be a difference. It's going to be a Sahityik Prem Patra also. And when I read what she had written, it's a two-hour play. What you must have said, he saw it online. So it was 16 minutes. So for me, it was amazing, the power of his words. And each time I read those letters, I used to look at my husband and say, you know, I mean, imagine this gentleman for so many years wrote these kind of letters to his wife. You wrote me even one letter in this entire lifetime, I would be like, dhanya ho jaungi. But that's when I, you know, this is what good writing does to you. There is a lot that you will understand, there's a lot that you won't understand at any given point of time, but it starts evolving you, your thinking. Mm. And when KK uncle and Ilaji said that ye karte hain, Varun and I both were like, we have to do this because it's a different experience, it's a different thought, and it's still so relevant in today's times. And yes, so the association with Dharmveer Bharti continues, and I am forever enamored, and I'm always delighted to read his works, because each time you see a different facet. You know, there are many things that you have thought and you're not sure whether what you're thinking really makes sense, or you at times are at a loss of words to express what you are thinking. And when you read this and you say, oh my God, this is so beautiful, it gives you a certain direction. That's what I think each time when we are performing this play, even I play Radha, I read out Radha's poems.
Yeah.
And each time you see a different facet of a woman's personality. And suddenly it's not only about the mythology of Radha, but as a thinking, living woman. So it's amazing that a man wrote from her point of view. It's so feministic. Yes.
Yeah. So before we open this up to the audience, because there are lots of questions now flowing in, was there any work that you were doing that's been interrupted by COVID-19 and the lockdown that you would want to go back to? I mean, because a lot of people have had their lives interrupted very abruptly.
Yes.
So how has it been with you?
Work did get interrupted. There was this web series that we were filming and we have 10 days of work left. Yes. You know, we are inside our house. We are in very good, we are doing fine because we are at home and very happily there. Life has changed because now my son has online schooling every day. So I have to sit with his books. So that's something that's taking away all my time. And then there's the house and I'm suddenly the queen of the house. Now all the house helps are, you know, in isolation. So there is no time to breathe. There's a lot of work to do. And there's a lot of, you know, one is thinking a lot these days about how life is going to change. And there's a lot of contemplation of what will happen to the whole world, our people, our migrants, everything. I think one is being affected by everything, the animals around us. Life become too conscious of everything around me and everything that I'm doing at the moment. So going back to life again, the way it was, is not going to be the same ever again, I think. Work will happen.
As a performing artist who acts for a living, you have to go out and work with people. So how would that be? I mean, in the new normal, will it be, you know, back to what you were before this, or will life be different? How do you go to a set where there are hundreds of people working now?
We can't do that. We can't do that. I wouldn't put myself at risk. I wouldn't, because I'm going to come back home to my child and to my parents at home. Family. It's not going to be possible. Yeah. Yes, that's a risk that I'm not willing to take right now, unless and until there's an SOP, that's what you call it, in place. It's going to be very difficult, though people are trying to get back to shooting. They say we'll have limited units, but an actor is not going to be able to perform with his mask on. So I think there's going to be a long time before we actually start shooting. And till then, I don't know how things will pan out for a whole lot of artists. Some of us who are invested would be fine. Some of us who are not. It's going to be really sad. But I guess we'll have to find a way out. There will be a new. I believe there are people who are shooting for their ad films from home, which is good.
Yeah, I know.
They're finding alternatives. I believe there's a show on some Marathi channel which is being shot from actors' respective homes. So there's a new again. We'll see how it unfolds, really. Not that it won't affect us. It is affecting us. But we don't have a choice. None of us has a choice. So we'll have to see how life unfolds.
So, okay, Rajeshwari, it was wonderful talking to you. Rizwan, you can now come back. Yeah, Rizwan is going to be back.
Thank you so much for such a wonderful discussion. Thank you, both of you, Mr. Saibal and Rajeshwari Sachdev. And I'm sure, you know, this discussion covered, you know, her body of work, right from theater to cinema, though she has, you know, huge body of work, over 40 films and television shows to her credit. But nevertheless, I think this discussion was very, very good. And I'm sure, you know, all acting talents and the people who belong to cinema, students who belong to cinema, you know, they have got many insight to the, you know, this world. I believe we missed one of the point in my introduction as well. She's a wonderful singer also. Rajeshwari is a wonderful singer. Yeah. She has, I believe, released...
Thank you!
So she has released 3 albums that I missed during my discussion. We have a few comments and a few questions as well. So we'll take up, you know, all comments one by one. Pooja Dahlia Karnade, she writes that she's a director's actor and actor's actress par excellence. So this is a comment from Pooja. And then we have some Shabana Azmi. She writes, yes, I have seen her dance in Nach Baliye, fantastic performance. So she remembers your Nach Baliye performance till now.
Is it Shabana ji? Is it Shabana ji?
No.
Okay, I thought like, thank you.
Her namesake.
Her picture there. Shabana Azmi. Yeah, but that's her picture there.
Yeah. So we will keep on.
I would like to see your face, Shabana ji. Yeah.
And then Shraddha Rizwan says, gorgeous Rajeshwari. Lots of appreciations in the beginning. And then we move to the next question. The question is from Umar Azmi. He says, ma'am, you said that you have been in industry for past 30 years. So what do you have to say about the fact that some actors are not able to accept the fact that they age? Or is this on the industry that it is not willing to take newcomer?
First question I understood. What is the second question?
He's asking that, is this on the industry that they are not willing to take the newcomers?
Newcomers. I mean, they don't want newcomers
to enter?
Yeah.
That's not true. About aging, nobody likes to age. Let's be honest. that's something that that's a fact that you have to accept. And if you don't, then you will become very irrelevant very soon. Because see, the problem also is many a times people know, even if you don't look the age, people know. इतने सालों से हम देख रहे हैं, काम कर रहे हैं, इतनी तो उम्र होगी. तो आपको बहुत बार इसलिए भी काम नहीं मिलेगा क्योंकि इतना तो आप होंगे ही, तो ये रोल आप कैसे कर सकते हैं. तो ये भी होता है, you know, there's a lot of prejudices at work. But well, to each his own, you know, whatever makes you comfortable. You want to look your age, you don't want to look your age, there's a certain way you are, so it's okay. About people coming into the industry, no, there is no truth in that. People don't want you to come into the industry. Yes, if your question is whether you know, being a star daughter or a star son is going to help you and they get more privileges, then yes. And there is, they will get it, and why not? Matlab, one cannot be angry with a certain people born into a privilege. But at the end of the day, if they have to stay on, then it's going to be on their own talent. And everybody has their own destiny. Kal aap ye kahein ki raja ka beta raja ke ghar mein kyun paida hua, to phir ye kya sawal hua? But iska matlab ye nahi hai ki you won't get your chance in life, because it's a huge place and there's work for everyone. It might happen differently, but the basharte ki aap ye na sochein ki meri zindagi usi tarah se chale aur usi tarah ki offers mujhe mile, you might find your own path.
So yeah, we have one sort of comment from Shraddha Rizwan. She says that so true, one needs to keep polishing one's talent, else they rust. I think you sort of made this point in your during your talk. Yes. So she is also an actress, so she compliment on that. She further says, Rajeshwari, just a minute, I missed that question also. So I'll continue with that.
I find you and Divya very similar in many ways. What do you think that you are from Instagram? Okay, I'll tell Divya that, but
next question.
No, I can answer that question. See, what happens is, not all the work that you want is going to come your way. And there's going to be a whole lot of work that comes your way that you don't want to do. So somewhere at the end of it, there is this that you're offered and this that you will choose from. And also it's your own personality. If you're a go-getter, you want to step out and go looking for that work, it might get be a little different. If I was like that, if that came easy to me, maybe yes, I would have been in a few more other projects that I wish to be in. But that's how it is. And I'm very happy the way it's turned out. As long as I stay relevant, as long as I'm working, zindagi bahut lambi hai and I am still around. And every actor is hopefully going to stay around and keep getting work that's going to challenge him at some point or the other and keep life excited, you know, keep you excited about life.
So Rizwan, just one question. Since you're talking about age, do you think scriptwriters are writing enough roles for, you know, actresses who've been around for 30 years, 35 years? I mean, are there, or do you think that is changing? I mean, that part of the industry?
See, I don't know how much is being done, but in the last 3-4 years, the kind of films that I've done, though they happen to be in Marathi, there have been roles that have been written with my age in mind, let's say. They are very important characters that I played, very interesting parts. I think also the subject matter of films have changed in the last few years. We have, you know, for the longest time I was wondering when our films used to happen, ki jitni ladkiyan hain kabhi kaam nahi karti kya? You know, matlab, there has to be something about my life that it need not be about a working woman, but as a woman, aap jo kaam kar rahe hain, it could also be a part of your character. For example, now, fortunately, you are seeing career women in films. They have a profession. Of course, the main story might be something else. So thankfully, there's a little change. I believe that, yes, now, of course, Neena ji also, if you see, I think she first made this noise and correctly that there have to be roles written for her. Mm. And see, today, yes, you find her doing such amazing parts. You know, I'm always a very hopeful person. I'm very, very optimistic and positive in life. For me, yes. As long as the ball is set rolling, it's good.
Great. So we have another question from Anisha Badani. She says, you have done awesome versatile roles. Do you still have a dream role you want to do?
That's
hey, Anisha. you know, I stopped thinking about that a long time ago. there is nothing called this one dream role. I think whatever is luckily offered to me, as long as it's a very important story to tell, a role that has enough layers, where you see a woman as a woman, not what is expected of her, but as an individual, I think that's an important role to do, and it's a difficult role to do at the same time. It'll challenge me at that point, because I think every woman's going to be different, but that one role, I can't think of any one role, but maybe now that you ask, and now I'm thinking about it, I read this book called The Palace of Illusions, and I think Draupadi's part, the way it's written, is awesome. Yes, so maybe if ever that role, that film is made, I would like to play Draupadi. What do you say, Mr. Chatterjee?
Yeah, of course. Why? You should do whatever your heart wants.
So they have very complex characters, interesting characters, because to say this is what I wouldn't want to limit myself. Anything that has some meat is good for me.
So but we have one more comment from Shabana. She says, it was long back in 90s, you and Varun Badola performing final show of Nach Baliye, and suddenly he went blank. So how you handled the tragic end? I felt sorry. You both were my favorite, and I wanted both of you win.
Thank you so much. It was very difficult. See, as an actor, the worst nightmare for an actor on stage is to forget his lines in the middle of a performance. Mm-hmm. And that's a worst nightmare. Till then, I never knew what it was, because whenever I went on stage, I always felt like I was a queen and nothing could go wrong. But not that it hasn't happened. So what happened with Varun was that he blanked out. This is quite a common phenomenon. It happens. But on stage, what happens is your time and space. And this moment where you blank out, it just lasts a few seconds. Then you gather yourself and you come back. Either a co-actor will help you or you will find a way to resume the play. Unfortunately, when he blanked out, it was a dance piece. So even a 2 second lag there, the music has gone, then to get it back together is very difficult. So yes, it was tragic, not because he forgot, but because the kind of insinuations that came our way, ki aap logon ne haarne ke kitne paise liye, aur aapne jaan boot karke kya, oh yes, we faced a whole lot of that. We used to go to shopping malls and
match fixing.
Yes, hum shopping mall jaate the, main sach keh rahi hu, and this, I remember seeing a gentleman, and he actually, everybody thought we were their property. I understand that you were passionate about us, you were rooting about for us, but to come in the middle of a mall and say, so Varun saab, kitne paise khaye? And I had tears in my eyes, and I also had a co-actor ask me, Raj, sach batana, kya tha wo? And I said, you know what, you don't put in 20 years of your life doing something to give it all away at the last moment. Sure. You know, if you have learned classical dance and put in 14, 15 years dancing every day for hours together, you never let it go for just anything. So that was quite a learning. And after that, you know, every time I go on stage, there's a little preparation. I just hope nothing of that sort happens to me. So one is trying to be very focused and very much there. So, yes.
Yeah, so after this tragic moment, we have a very nice appreciation from Mushira Khan. She says, Bahu Pratibhavan Kudi to you.
Pratibhavan. But what would be the Punjabi word for Pratibhavan? Pratibhavan.
Punjabi.
And Anisha Badani, again, you know, he sort of compliment that moment to you. He says, wow, Shabana, see, that's something I forget. It was remarkable how she handled during Nach Baliye, actually. So he again compliments on that. Then I think we have one more. Yeah, Shraddha ji is again here. What should one keep doing to keep the artist's soul alive in oneself, even if one is not able to showcase one's talent? Ubay, can you put up this question on the screen? Shraddha's question on the screen.
Manna, when you are going through a downtime, I mean, not working, how do you keep your
Yes.
Creative juices flowing.
I would say ki acting aaine ke samne karo. But it's a good time to watch performances, some good films. It's important to read a lot. Although I'll be very honest, I don't get much time. Or I can tell you my son's textbook backwards at the moment. But but yes, it's important to keep reading. See, when I went to do my master's also, my father said, you have the time. Why don't you just go? And see, math was something that I could never do. So I decided to take up the arts. So when I started doing my master's in literature, the reason was not because, I needed one more certificate, but I really wanted to understand, read more, see how you approach things, how it is done, how do you approach any kind of topic or a character. And when you sat in the lecture and you heard your professor and you saw the various perspectives, you grow as an actor. So that was primarily my reason for doing it, to sit and listen to someone else give you another perspective. So it is important to listen to good people, to read as much, to listen to good music, and just be alive to the world around you.
True that. I think we have one more question from Pratiksha now. He says, what is one advice you would like to give to budding theatre artists?
Budding
theatre actors. Well, join a good theatre group. Learn from the scratch. Watch a lot of plays. If you can get yourself trained in an institute, if you're lucky, you have the time and the resources, wonderful. Baki, aur mein kya ko? Baki, whenever you get some good work, work towards it. I think it starts with a good theatre group.
True. So Anisha Badani sort of have last comment of the day today. He says, thanks for being truthful and straightforward. All the best. So it's like,
thank you.
You've done a Tamil film, Rajeshwari?
No, I haven't. I don't know. Some Wikipedia says I've done. No, I haven't done a Tamil film.
But you haven't done a Punjabi film, have you?
I've done one Punjabi film.
Yes. Which one was this? And when was this?
I got married in 2004, 2003, I think I did it.
Okay. And so you've never been approached by Punjabi producers, directors to do films?
Not really.
Why is that? Because there are lots of Punjabi films are made these days. I mean, there was a time when you had only a handful.
Initially, when they were being made, those days when Punjabi films were being made, they used to be a typical kind. Aajkal badi achhi achhi Punjabi films milti hain. This whole location. Yeah. Bahut achhi achhi films banti hain. But us waqt agar ek aadhi aayi hongi, maybe I wouldn't have been very equipped about them. Maybe I don't even remember. But no, not I haven't been offered very many Punjabi films. This was a very nice film that I did.
Okay.
Yeah.
So is it available somewhere?
I don't know. I'll find out.
See it. I haven't seen it.
Yeah, this was in 2003, and I remember. We are Mumbai. I'm Mumbai girl, so I speak Punjabi. I always used to say that main apni Punjabi film mein na main to Bombay wali Punjabi bolti hu, but I was surprised by it. But when I did that film, I was quite impressed with myself. I said, not bad. I did this.
So okay, this one. Yeah.
Yeah, we have the last comment of the day today. Then I'll have my question at the end of the show. Last comment is from Shraddha Rizwan. She says, thanks for answering both the questions so wonderfully. Rajeshwari, you are blessed with a content heart which pumps so much of energy.
Thank you so much for saying that. Thank you.
So I think nothing can be better than to end up this show now today. So I have last question, Rajeshwari. You have worked with both Indian filmmakers as well as the foreign filmmakers. You know, how the foreign filmmakers are different for actors basically. Are they more organized? Are Indian actors like you are more comfortable with the working with foreign filmmakers or the Indian? How are their production style? Actually, how do they approach the actor?
See, in 1992 I had done that film. Then I did another film a little later. But see, I won't be the right person to comment. I think Priyanka Chopra today will be able to answer that question best because she's actively working there. So we must ask this question to her. How different is it? But yes, if I went to do something there soon, I don't know how soon after the COVID, I will answer this question then. How different we are now. But then, yes, there was a vast difference there. That was huge.
Great.
Yeah, between the time.
I think in the beginning of my career, yeah.
Yeah, Mr. Saibal. Yeah.
Yeah, between the time you started in the industry here and now, how much change have you seen in terms of the way the industry works? I mean, obviously things have changed. There's more corporatization. There's a more professionalism, I suppose. But you've acted with directors who were also very professional. Obviously, someone like Shyam Babu wasn't someone who would, you know.
That's what I'm saying. You know, I think hum bigdi aur aate hain. Humko itna bigad diya na. I worked with such good people in the beginning of my career that I started expecting the same kind of professionalism everywhere that I went. So, which is not possible even today. But one has adapted to that. What has changed much? Yes, we have good vans. We have very glamorous and well-equipped vans now. And with this whole corporatization, I really don't know. But, you know, correct me if I'm wrong, because you are the one with the strategy who would answer this best in terms of, you know, filmmaking. When the whole multiplex thing came in, we thought there's going to be this place for the small filmmakers and the independent filmmakers to showcase. But things have changed. It's not like that. You make a film and there are some very good people who are making films, small films, and they go and release the film. And you were thinking it's going to be a cakewalk. And then you go to these multiplexes and then you want to catch the film. One day you see the show is at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So you decide tomorrow I'm going to go and catch this film. You reach there, only aaj to 6 baje ka show hai. Aapko to theaters hi nahi milti, aapko to kuch bhi nahi milta. So in the end, it's all about the big players today.
You're absolutely right. Because when the multiplexes came, we were told that we'll have more choice, we'll get a wider variety of films. But that's not happening. I mean, that happened for a very brief while, but then the big players took over. Yeah, initially.
For a brief period.
Fir uske baad the big players came in. And when there's a big film releasing, then they flood the entire multiplex. So there's no room for the smaller film. But that happens all the time.
Yeah, so I feel that... you know, every time we are faced with a new set of challenges, things haven't really changed much that way, except that water finds its own level. So we find another way, we go onto the web, we go in for the platform, you know, online platform. Somewhere or the other, we find a way to showcase our work. But yes, apart from the fact that our films are more global and appeasing a global audience, the commercial films, yes, some good stories told. But I think in every generation, there's going to be one set of filmmakers telling you a good story. So, yeah.
True that. I think very well put up. Yeah, there is no scope for, you know, small filmmakers. Only film festivals have kept them live, actually.
Thankfully for the film festivals. I mean, the kind of films that I have really seen are thanks to the film festivals.
Absolutely.
After festivals bhi nahi ho rahe COVID ke wajah se.
online
ho rahe, but this is on the same thing. I mean, watching a film on the big screen and watching it on your laptop. I mean, luckily, not the same thing.
Luckily, all top film festivals of the world, you know, they've come together for an online film festival. Yeah, which is
starting on the
29th. From
29th. Starting on the
29th. You
have to put a big chadar,
a projector. Yeah, that needs to be done. So, thank you. With this, we have come to the end of the session now. And thank you for such an animated discussion today. And I'm very privileged and honored to have both of you on the show today. It's been such an honor to have you on the show today. And this was the fifth episode. And I think the audience have received this very well. I should thank you once again that you joined us today. You know, it's paid your precious time for this episode today. Thank you so much once again.
Thank you, Rizwan sahab. Thank you very much.
Okay, bye,
and thank you so much. Thank you so much, Mr. Saibal Chatterjee. It was an honor talking to you. Yeah, and I'm so glad I met
pleasure.
You.
My pleasure.
Please take care.
Although, like, remotely. Only remotely.
Yes.
I mean, I'll see you when you come to Delhi to do a play on the stage, probably next, whenever that is. I don't know how far away that is.
Soon.
Yeah, okay.
It's been such an honor. It's been such an honor. Bye-bye. Thank you so much. Stay safe. Thank you. I think it's been a wonderful episode today with Madam Rajeshwari and Saibal Chatterjee ji. Tomorrow again at same time 11:30 a.m. we'll be back with yet another media veterans for you. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Good day. Thank you so much.